go.
I'm gonna stand on my foot.
Everybody? Brian, ready?
there.
Yeah, bro. That sounds good. Brian, yeah, bro. Killer. A couple things. I'm going to start backwards, okay? At the end of the song, what you just played these two chords, kind of like you were answering. Keep going. Now, what's interesting about what you just played is it was a section, the big solo section, where everybody was kind of organically group improvising together, which I love that. That's like my whole, I love group improvisation. I think no solo, I would say that, but I just like that better than solos. It's just such an energy, you know? What's funny is you were doing like this rhythmic thing, but you had rhythm going on here, you had rhythm going on here, and there was also rhythm going on along the horns. I felt like you could have took inspiration from what they were playing. He was dealing with the blues. She was coming with some at the top was just like freaking amazing. Yeah. And so you had all these, and you're like right here in this altissimo, like this kind of mid range in between. It was a vibe, you know? All you had to do was support them harmonically. I felt like that would have lifted the whole, because I mean, you guys lifted by yourself, but what happened was they got to a point where they couldn't go anymore. That's where you come in at. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But the rhythm is cool, but this is where experience teaches you to use more than what you know to play. Mm-hmm. This is experience right here. Because you get a cat who played that section, all it needed was somebody to throw at them harmonic suggestions versus rhythm suggestions. Brian, the rhythm is there. It's there. You could have just been, play for me. Man, then it would have completely took off. Mm-hmm. Even to the point to where it could have took off to where the time just went. Because it opens up, and they hear that. The harmony affects what rhythms and what melodies everyone plays. And you control that just as well as bass. Experience will teach you, too, that you could have came away from that. You see what I'm saying? Teach you how to play with harmony a little bit more just to give them some more push, you know, going to the four, there's ways to stretch the entire span of that tune. And if you put, that's what will separate, you know, I don't want to say, because honestly, man, y'all playing at a very high level, so it's not about, you can just tell, experience shows you other ways to make music more impactful, you know? With this band, I don't even want to talk about technical stuff, because I feel like this, you know how to share it. So you shared it, you got a problem playing. I don't even hear any major issues. What I do hear, though, is in the melody as well, that you're playing the piano part in, you can be a lot more articulate. Mm-hmm. You should have way more dynamic range in your playing. In the other band, your dynamic range worked for you. But right now, in this situation, your dynamic range is working against you. Like, you should be able to have a wide range of, like, I mean, it should be like, that's touch, that's practice, that's classical, you know. I don't have to tell you, you know exactly what it is. Like, that's you understanding the range of the piano. And you can help in this situation. You see what I'm saying? So right here, you were the strong link. Here, you can be considered the weak link. Even in your solos, this is for everybody. Remember this, do not give up hope on your solos. This is something I say all the time. Do not give up hope on your solos. When you're young, you constantly do it. You're playing a solo, and you don't like the idea that you play, and then you immediately start searching for more ideas. That happens even with professionals. You immediately search for a new idea. No, don't give up hope on your solos. Let your band members help you get through your idea. Hmm. You know what I mean? Let everyone help you. If you have a brain, he did it a couple times. He went from playing this, and Brian started playing, and he looked up at Brian, But then, let me tell you what he did. He lost hope on it, and he went, and then he came back to it, you know, trying to, like, still, man, when you get an idea, hold on to it. What that also does is it makes you play with space. It makes you play with space. It makes you actually let your band members play with you, you know? When you have an idea, you have to think about it. Don't just go run on sentences, man. Put some periods in there, some commas, you know? Because I can hear you doing it. I can hear you, like, searching. But your whole solo shouldn't be a search. At some point, you should have the story, and you should be telling it. You should know what you're about to say. You know that vibe when you play a good solo, and you can hear what you're about to play about five measures ahead? You can hear it all the way ahead. Mm. That's a good solo. But then you know those solos where it's like, I don't know what I'm going to play next. You see what I'm saying? That's where vocab comes in. That's experience. That's what we do this for. You know what I mean? So you can learn how to, like, always be at an optimal level. When you reach a high, I feel like the level that we're all trying to reach is where our mistakes are stories. That's what we're all trying to reach. Mistakes are stories. So even if you don't like it, even if you didn't mean to play it or it didn't come out how you heard it, this is the story and we're rolling with it. You just that vulnerable. You feel me? You know? Now, what's your name again?
Gary.
My bad.